of the most powerful features of working inside of Blender are the different modes. Now, when you open up any sort of 2D animation project, the first mode, the default mode, is going to be the drawing mode. And I can see that right here inside the interface. Okay, and of course, as one might imagine, I'm in the pencil tool at the moment. Now, with the pencil tool and in the draw mode, as one might imagine, I can go in, I can just make some lovely shapes. I can just draw to my heart's content. There we go. And I'm a happy camper, as my little guy shows. However, this is not the only environment in which we get to work with. This is not the only mode. We get to change our selection system so that we can manipulate our drawings in a number of different ways. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Of course, in the draw mode, I get access to all of my drawing tools. However, if I change that mode just by clicking on this little pull-down menu here, you can see that we have some other modes that will allow us to continue to change and edit and to manipulate our drawings. Let's go into object mode, which is probably the most important mode in the 2D animation world in addition to the draw mode. Let's go into it real fast. Now, immediately you can see some things have changed. Now, let's go over those changes. Our drawing tools have been replaced with a whole bunch of transform tools. And notice that all of my strokes here have been slightly adjusted. And now it's just like one big stroke with this orange outline. When you're in object mode, you're now selecting everything on that stroke object. And I'm going to draw your attention real fast over here into the outliner, this little list, because these are a list of all the different objects. Each one of these objects in the list can be manipulated in its entirety in object mode. Now remember, when I drew out my little crazy doodad here, it was just one big swooping line, the third stroke was a circle, 4 and 5 were the eyes, and the last stroke I did was this goofy little smile. So it's a whole series of individual strokes while in draw mode. But now that I'm in object mode, check it out. I can go over into the transform tool, and I can move the entirety of that drawing around. I know it's a little hard to see on the screen capture because the orange outline kind of goes into this ghosted white, but you can see pretty quickly here that I can manipulate everything on that layer, which is pretty cool. Of course, that's the move. This is rotate. I can rotate it around, which is pretty neat. This one's scale. As one might imagine, we can scale it disproportionately, or this little green box in the center will allow us to scale it proportionally along to in this case, two axes. And then lastly, we have this universal transform tool, which will allow us to move, rotate, and scale all in one tool, which is pretty cool. So object mode is going to allow us to select and then manipulate the entire container, the entire object, inside of this system, which is pretty cool. Now, right now, we're working with this universal transform tool, or just the move tool, but if we wanted to go back into the selection tool, that's this guy over here. This is the box selection tool, which will allow us to select any number of objects inside the scene itself, which is pretty cool, okay? So these modes are super important. We can go back and forth at any time. Notice that I'm still on this object that's called stroke, okay? I can add to it, and then when I return to object mode, yeah, there we go. Now I can continue moving and manipulating the entirety of that container, which is pretty neat. Now, in addition, we also have edit mode. And edit mode is going to give us a whole new level of granular control over the strokes and the objects with inside of our scene. Check it out. So I'm in edit mode. Of course, we get the move tool, but what are we moving now? Now we can go in and we can move individual pieces, okay, which is pretty neat. Instead of moving everything, I'm kind of going one step closer into the system itself. I can grab this stroke, for example. I can move it around. Maybe I want the eyes to be off my character like this for whatever reason. It's just pretty neat. Now, in addition to moving entire stroked lines, we can also go in, and if you look at these different options, we can go in and get very granular. Maybe I want to move just a little bit. Well, this first one right here, this is going to select all the dots that create that line. I can go in and play with just one dot, for example. Or I can grab the entire one, the entire stroke, like I had earlier. Or I can grab segments of it. And this one's a little bit more difficult on lines that were created with the pen tool. If you were working with a shape that was created with the sphere tool or a cube tool, then this one here is going to get a little bit more pertinent to what we're to that operation. In addition, we can also do some curve editing, so we get some fantastic granular control. If I can just get in there and select it, see if I can grab one of those dots. Here we go. Yeah, I don't think I can do it on this particular stroke, but we can do some curve editing as well. Let's see if I can get one. I'm not working with a sphere at the moment. Yeah, can't grab it on a line that was created with the pen tool. If I was working with the sphere, I'd be able to go in and grab Bezier curves as well. So point being that the edit mode is going to allow us to go in and do further control, a little bit more granular, localized edits on the individual strokes. Object mode, this is everything that's on the layer. Edit mode, individual parts and pieces, which is pretty cool. And of course, we have draw mode, which will allow us to continue drawing and adding new shapes in. Now, I'm not going to talk too much about some of these other modes because weight paint and vertex paint, these are incredibly advanced. They have their functions inside the larger Blender 2D animation interface. However, I'm not going to talk about them today. In addition, I would encourage you to check out the sculpt mode. This is a way for us to organically change our shapes. It's kind of a little fun. It takes some practice and some really strong understanding of how all the sculpting tools are going to influence your curves, but it is kind of a neat addition to the tool set, and I encourage you to explore and experiment with that as you go through your experience animating and creating artwork inside of Blender 3D. It's pretty fun. So check out all these modes. It's a helpful part of the process, especially when animating objects. And one of our tasks this week is to animate a pendulum. And being able to work in object mode and move and animate in object mode is going to be a very helpful addition to your animation production process.